And at that time, none of the disciples were totally convinced who Jesus really was. And he asks Peter, "So who do you say I am?" And Peter says, "You are the Christ." And what does Jesus respond? He says, "Flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven."
Yeah.
Salvation comes not because we convince ourselves. You can't take an oath, you can't say the words and get saved. I mean, that's part of it. But even if you can't speak, you can be saved, right? So we know it's something spiritual, and that's what Jesus was getting at with Peter. And what would happen to how the church would be born. It was going to be through the revelation of the Holy Spirit, given revelation to them who he was. And that's the same thing we lean on when we evangelize, when we proclaim the gospel. Those aren't just words. They're spiritually given, and they're spiritually revealed. And the Holy Spirit intercedes into a person's heart and gives them revelation of who Jesus is. That's how you become born again. If it was flesh and blood, it couldn't happen. And Jesus was showing him that. And then what later happened was when Jesus was going to be crucified, so the Holy Spirit could dwell in believers, because at that point they could not, because we were unclean vessels. We were separated from God, as she was saying. But Jesus was going to pay an ultimate price for every sin that ever would ever be committed, so that people could be justified in God and be righteous in his sight, and therefore he could dwell through the Spirit of God in them. And that's why he says, "I must go. I must do this." And the Comforter would come, and he would come and live inside them. That's how Christ lives in us. And if you've never experienced that, you can walk, you can walk in, commitment to a certain extent. You know, people commit to doing things and they follow through. But you won't ever really follow Christ. You won't ever really be born again until the Spirit of God comes into you and Christ dwells in you. And even our faith comes from God. Scripture says. Again, God empowers people to come to Christ. He enables them by his grace. Grace just isn't a word. It's the movement of God in people's lives. And the Spirit of God comes in and he changes your heart, and Christ begins to dwell in you physically by the Spirit of God. And that's how you are born again. And what water baptism does, it signifies what has occurred in you.
Yes.
You've been engulfed into the Holy Spirit, into the life of Christ, and then you've been raised just as Jesus was raised.
Yes.
And that's what baptism really signifies for us.
Yes.
So I just want to make sure we understand that this is the power of the Holy Spirit that born us into the kingdom of God.
Amen.
It's not just dead words. It's not just a blind hope. And if you've never experienced that, God wants that in your life. Believe me, I went to church more than a few times, and I tried to be good, and I tried to commit my life to Christ, and it never worked.
Thank you.
Never worked.
Thank you.
And within a week, I was out with the guys I hung with, doing what we did. And I was like, well, that was good, but, here we go. This is it. And then, many times somebody would take me to church and I'd, do something, make a commitment, last a few days. But when I became born again, when the Spirit of God came into my life and the Holy Spirit revealed who Christ was, it was a new day. Yeah, I have ups and downs like everybody else.
Yes.
But that birth experience does not just flee.
No.
It stays with you. And that's what you need really in your life. So we want to again give that opportunity to anybody. We'll pray for you here today. There's plenty of people here that know the Lord. So we're going to do some worship. But if you just want to come forward at any point, somebody will reach out and pray for you.
Yeah, even just for prayer.
I need to get to my key here. Hold on a sec.
God, you're wonderful today. You're doing things we never expected. We just worship you. We just thank you, Jesus. Reveal yourself, Holy Spirit. Father, Father, your glory, your glory. Thank you, Jesus. Angels answer to prayers, God. Thank you, Jesus.
For thou, O Lord, art a shield. Thank you.
in my soul. Spring up well. Spring up well. It can be that night. I've got a river of light going now.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Makes the rain and walk in the light. Hey, with you. It opens prison doors and sets a captive free. I've got a river of life and it's flowing out to me. Spring up, oh, spring up, oh, God, make me whole. Spring up, oh, well, spring up, oh, well.
Sister Anna.
Thank you, Jesus.
Would you ask one?